No, it's better, isn't it?
It's fine on my end. I just hear you just fine.
Yeah, no, it's everything. Okay, because I had so many windows open on my computer, so it was Rachel Ghost was live on one window. Okay. This is the first time I had, we can talk Swedish also, but maybe there's only nine people here, so maybe we must talk English.
We just go back and forth. If we have to say some nasty shit, we say it in Swedish and Norwegian.
Yes. This is the first time, Stunty, that I have been this live stream with people live on screen also.
Right under the screen, you should
Yes.
have options. If you can click on different setting of how it exactly, you see?
Oh, okay, I see.
Try them all so you see what
Yeah,
you, the
yeah,
options
yeah.
you have.
Oh, this is perfect also. And I
This is
can.
the one that we usually have, yeah.
Yes. And I can click on the right side for this comment.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And you can make Pass Radio an administrator so he can select comments for you if you don't have time to check them.
Oh yeah, if I click a star on it, isn't it?
Yeah, or
Now that,
something like that. No, if you click, I'm not sure. I think it will give you like a wrench or something.
okay, yeah. I will not start with that first, but
No, take your time.
yeah. I was so fed up with all this politics talk on Rachel's stream, and I need some music in my life because music is the soul for me. So.
Like it seems I haven't watched it in some time, Rachel, but it's all about the drama and the politics these days, it seems. Or like Mezzi hyping Rhino reissues or something like that.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's fun.
And when you pop up, was that because I posted the stream, the link to StreamYard?
No, I'm subscribed to you. So
Okay.
I got I was
Message.
I just got like in my feed that you were going live.
Okay. But and then you can come up automatically, or you just pop
Because
up
you put the link on the in
in the
the
stream.
in
Yeah,
the
okay. Let me see. Let me see. I will
You
do
put
this
it.
now and see. Yeah, I can see this. This is so this is the
Click.
link I send out now. This one.
You
Yeah.
exactly.
Okay, so when people click on that link, they come up in this window under us. Yeah.
Exactly.
But I have two window. I have two machines. You know, see here? That's my streaming.
All right.
Yeah,
You
so you
see the
can,
quality is a little more blurry.
yeah, so you see, let me see.
Ah, okay. Oh, you have it's a sort of
It's
iPad. Okay.
an iPad pointing to my Technics turntable, yeah. Yeah, and I have had in the beginning, I have Rachel Ghost on the stream back here also. I can do that with no sound and see what's happened.
Yeah, I think it's better to watch the through the window than
Yeah,
that.
let me
I
see.
got some
Okay.
records today in the
Yeah,
mail.
yeah, yeah. Let me see. I take away this. Well, how can I take away? Okay, I can do that. This remove from stage, and then I can make you big. Like no, other way, the other way.
Exactly. You select
Select that.
basically, no, you see the on your big window. You have
Yeah.
under it, you have me and you in small screens, and you just click on the one where I am.
Okay, under the window. Okay.
You know the two small windows where you have the big window, which is where
Oh,
you
okay. Yeah.
exactly.
Oh.
And now you click on the one under where it's
Under
just
there. That's what it's called. Stunty. The small
Exactly.
window. So I click on that.
I think, or you know, there's the op. Yeah, I think you click on that, or maybe there's the option. You know, the one with the three dots or something, and there you have the
Solo layout, like that.
exactly.
Yeah, okay, yeah. Oh, Polish,
Polish.
yeah.
Yeah, it's a series. It's basically an autumn festival in Warszawa
Yes.
that's been going on since the 50s or 60s. And each year they were putting recordings of everything that was going on in the festival. The first year it was one LP a year, the like the this is 85, this is 84, and they had like 10 different ones at that time. And okay, they're not all good, but the ones that are good are really, really good. And right now, they didn't press that many. And it's like modern classical, avant-garde, psychedelic, modern music. It's really cool. And often they're really cheap or super expensive because they're difficult to find. There's not many copies. So every time I can get one, I'm really happy.
But Stunty, how do you get this record? Do you use Discogs or you use other places to get them? Or
yeah, I use for stuff like that I will not find locally. Yeah, I use Discogs, I use eBay, I use record dealers. I know people from around the world and I ask them. And yeah, I assume you do the same. You must use Discogs a lot as well, right?
Yeah, I've tried Discogs maybe 5-6 times, and yeah, so not so much. But usually, I have three people in my town that have so many records. They have collected in many, many, many years. So they sell privately. So I know them. So it's going like Facebook message privately. So I buy a lot of those, and then I fly to Oslo, and Oslo have 2-3 shops, and in Bergen.
So why didn't you come to my music festival, huh?
Yeah, because you know, it was this in this football tournament. My kid is 16 years old, in Pito, and that was on from Wednesday to Sunday, and I think your festival was that weekend.
Yeah, it was Friday to Sunday that the same week. I think.
Yeah, so if your festival had been the week after, or then I will take my son and drive down to you because I had 1 week extra after the football with my kid.
Yeah, so, it's 2.5 hours from Oslo.
Yeah, but for me it's.
For you,
it's easier to drive to Sweden and drive down if I'm on holiday. But I have a plan to go to Luleå in, I think it was in September.
Luleå is beautiful.
Yeah.
For those who don't know, for the people who don't know from Sweden, Luleå has probably one of the biggest sand beach in the world. And you have, like, the water in the summer is like 30, 35 degrees because the water is quite shallow and the Baltic Sea is... I mean, it's the summer, so the sun is always there, so it's super warm, and the Baltic Sea also doesn't have that much salt in it. It's the same level of salt as the human body, so if you put your eyes in the water, it doesn't attack or sting or anything. It's beautiful.
Yeah, that's and I see in September 20. How can I show thing on my computer on the screen? Can I share that? Is that possible?
I think you can, but I think you can if you have like the paying option.
I don't have that. Yeah.
Or I personally haven't figured out how to do it myself. So
yeah, but I can copy a link or a page and put it on the. Let me see. Yeah, because I have a favorite artist that I was listened to last year on a show in Oslo. She's called Hannah Aldrich, and I have this is the tour page, and she's coming to Sweden to Luleå in September. Let me see. Yeah, 20th of September.
So, on what in Norway compared to Luleå? On the latitude, are you under, over, same level?
I'm over Luleå. Up
to really, really north.
Yeah. So I'm very close to Kiruna.
Yeah. Kiruna, well, Kiruna is not far away from Luleå, right?
No. It's 6 hours.
Oh, I thought it was less.
No. So I'm 2 hours with car from Kiruna to my town, Harstad.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, I was mixing up.
Yeah.
Luleå. I was thinking of Piteå for the beach.
Yeah. Now Piteå is very close to Luleå. It's only 30 minutes. So when I drive from Harstad, I drive from my place very close to Narvik. It's a town in North Norway. Then I crossed the border. I come to Bjørkliden. Bjørkliden and in Sweden and Riksgrensen. And then I drive to Kiruna. And then from Kiruna, then I come to Luleå and then Piteå and down.
It's funny because I did the other thing, the other way. I went from Luleå, Piteå, Kiruna, Abisko. And from Abisko, I walked, you know, in the summer to Narvik.
Yeah, it's a famous walk, they call it.
The Royal something, I think it's called.
Yeah, it's from the war or something. They have made movie about this also, yeah.
Everyone died.
That's
good advice from Bill K, by the way.
Start small, Ivan, learn all you can, yeah.
Just one thing at a time, like, and capitalize on every small thing.
Yeah. So if I have 3 guests, I can do like this. Okay, more guests on the side. And I switch back again. Yeah, this was very fun. Thank you so much, Dante, that you was coming up when, with my... Let me see here. Yeah, yesterday I played this music on my live stream.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's Rare Earth. It's some funky stuff from there.
I knew it.
And I also played this Ruben Howell. He made two records. It's some R&B funk music. And these two records, I don't get copyright when I play this because it's not so known. And this Tribe Ethnic Stew I played today also. I hope I didn't get the copyright strike or something.
You know, the copyright thing... you know, every Friday I do my stream when I play music for 2.5 hours. And I get about like, I very rarely get strikes. I get claims. The claims, you don't worry about it. Just means you can't monetize. But you shouldn't monetize when you're playing someone else's music.
No.
The only problem is sometimes you get, there's two types of claims. There's the claim that makes it, that officially makes it impossible to monetize. And there's the claims that block the video in certain territories, often in Russia and Belarus, so no problem.
I got that on my first stream, was blocked in Russia.
Yeah, no problem.
Okay.
No problem, huh? Like being blocked in Russia is not a problem. But if you get a strike, that's a problem. But I've never, ever got a strike, ever. And I've done like hundreds of them.
And this is the record Bill K was listened to on my stream, live stream. I took away that live stream because I had a little problem because when you have a live stream on StreamYard, you connect to YouTube. I didn't connect, so I had YouTube and StreamYard at the same time open. So it was bad quality, so I deleted those. Well,
the way I do it is I have my turntable plugged into a sound card and the sound card directly in the USB of the laptop.
Okay, because then you get
Yeah, and then SoundStream gives you the option of the sound source. Either you want to go with mic or it recognizes the sound card, and you do that, and then you have the sound directly from the turntable. Of course, you lose a little bit of quality, but it's much better.
Yeah. So let me see. This is I have just I'll take away that. I have just a mic in the front here. It's a very good mic. It's a Röde, so it's very nice. This one. I just bought it. Let me see. Oh.
Yeah.
But if you do that, Stunty, if you connect, I'm not sure if you can do it down here, but upstairs I have two red Technics turntables. I can show you one. But then, of course, it's a little problem when you talk because you don't have a microphone. So how did they hear you when you talk in between the songs?
So I can talk even over the music because I have the microphone plugged into the same sound card.
Okay, so both microphone. Okay, I will try that. See.
The only problem I have is that if I want to listen to the record in the headphones before I do I play it, I have a mixer and I have to change where I plug the headphones. So basically, I take the headphone out of the sound card in the mixer, back and forth, back and forth.
Or you can say you can change headphones if you have it.
Yeah. It's a little bit annoying, but when you do it every week, after a while, it becomes natural and normal.
I try that. I try that one on the stream that Jason have. Jason Jason.
Also, he plays good music.
Yeah, and I also play 4 or 5 songs from my turntable upstairs. I have 2 red ones. I can show you. I can pick. I can get it. Show you.
Yeah. Hello, Bill K. How are you? And Patrick Sweden. Yeah. We get Open Shield. Who else in Sweden? There's a couple of one guy in Stockholm who's doing VC Stockholm. Oh, nice. So which one is it? Which model is it?
It's I have 2 of those. This is you know, they made it in different colors.
So is it like the MK5, MK6, MK7?
SL 1200 M7L.
Okay. So you're 50, rich.
It cost a lot, So this is 50 University product limit is number 5479. So I have two of these.
Yeah, I need some like that, but it's too expensive. Mine are MK2, which are like 40 years old.
Yeah.
And they're starting to get a little bit tired, I must confess.
Yeah, and two of those 2 red turntables I use when I do DJ work. And I have one of this also. This is the expensive stuff. Let me see. You see it? It's SL1210 GAA. It's a limited edition. This cost a lot of money, this one.
Wow.
And I use this Technics integrated amp. This is R1000. It's a big one. Yeah.
Yeah,
and I just got these new cap speakers. that cost also a lot of money, but you know, I have not paid everything in one go. I have used many years, 10 years, to get more and more and more every second year or something like that.
Yeah. My problem is that, like, you're lucky that you only have like 5 sources for records, which means you can save for the gear. For me, it's always when I want to save for gear. No, there's always records.
Yeah, okay. You buy records. Yeah.
Yeah, I have like 15,000.
I have 3,200.
Yeah, that's a lot.
It's a lot of. So I have records behind me. You see, behind me, this is my living room behind me. But upstairs, I have a big room. With a lot of records. This is my house, you know. See, it's my.
So you work from home?
I work from home. Yeah, I work from home 3 days home and 2 days at work. But no, I'm gonna have some. I have 2 weeks summer holidays, but I'm gonna have more weeks in August, beginning of August.
Yeah. And do you work in the traditional Norwegian fields of economy? oil or gas?
yeah. Stunty, I start working when I was 19 years old in oil, in the Hydro, in oil company.
Yeah.
And I have working in the same company. So this year is going to be 50, in August 23, it's going to be 50 years since I start working. So that's good.
Well,
it's time
to retire, I think.
Yeah. So I'm going to be 59 in December. So my plan is to get retired when I'm going to get 62 or 63.
Yeah, so, that's nice. 62, like if you, especially since you started that early, like 19. But now I guess, like, so do you have, is like the 2 days you have to work there, is it like hard work or physical?
No. I work Tuesday and Wednesday I work at the office, but I work with data management.
So you're a manager, yeah.
Yeah, so I use with computers and everything. So I help the geologists and the geophysics people with a lot of data and stuff. So that I work with that. Yeah.
It's funny because when I was I think it was when I was 19 or 20, one summer I went to work for 5 weeks on an oil rig.
Okay.
as a summer job, just to do stupid shit, but to go get a lot of money and be blocked on the same place for 5 weeks, basically. That was something. don't worry about them. It's just them having their drama.
So if I click once, I take it away. Okay, yeah. Now, so, but Stunty, I'm so happy with my work, and that my work was, I have steady income all my years, and of course, then I can save money and buy records and equipment. And I was married I was divorced 10 years ago, and I only have two kids. One is 27.
You have 3,202 kids.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. So, but I was sick. I got sick last year. So I got this very, very, it's a serious sickness. I got MS. Have you heard about MS?
Yeah.
But so
you won't get cured from that. It's for life, right?
Yes, for life. Yeah. Mm. So, but they have good medicine for it, and therefore I work 3 days at home and 2 days at work, because I must not stress so much. If I get stressed, it can hit the head, and I got this MS attack or something. But it's summer now. I'm so happy, and I'm happy that you are here, Stunty. I love music, and I love to connect with people. And
it's just like us in Scandinavia. Like originally I'm from France, but now I'm kind of you know, I live in the forest. You know, let me show you.
Let's see if I can. You live outside Stockholm?
Yeah.
Okay. So can you make it with a car?
Yeah.
See? Oh, that's nice. You have a sea behind you there. Yeah. But it's not a bridge or you must cross or something. It's on the mainland.
You know, Stockholm is just islands.
Islands.
It's an archipelago, so it's just bridges everywhere.
Yeah.
I'm connected with bridges. Yeah.
Okay, I've been in Stockholm twice. I was on the Police concert there. Police had one of the last concerts they have. They have it, have that in Stockholm, I think. And it was in Stockholm. I think it was Stockholm. Yeah,
Stockholm has this big arena. Yesterday, I think it was there. My best friend, he went to see Bruce Springsteen.
And
it was horrible, he told me, because it was like 3.5 hours and 99% of the audience was like, you know, Sveriges Demokraterna.
Yeah, I should know.
Yesterday, you know, I spent some, it's, as you said, it's summer, so Cantarell, Jutron,
Mortebar.
Yeah,
that's good, yeah. Mm.
And yesterday I was picking wild raspberries, which tastes unique. So, you know, getting records, doing work, going in the forest, doing some work, going to have sauna. Do you have a sauna where you live?
I have not sauna here, but we have Arne. Hey, Arne. I think he's from Norway. Hey, Arne. Mm.
Hey, Arne.
Yeah. I don't have a sauna here, but we have what more?
But don't you live exactly like, isn't the water right outside your
room? Yeah, it's Harstad, but I have sauna, a floating sauna in the middle of my town. Yeah,
okay, yeah,
this is the new thing, they have this floating sauna, I should not be so warm. My illness is not so good.
Of course.
So I stopped that, but I loved it before. Yeah.
Yeah, I remember I had a couple of musicians I booked throughout my life that had MS, and it was very difficult for them to move. And often you become a bit like big, fat.
Tired. You get fatigue.
Tired. You have to have a cane to walk, a lot of people used to get diabetes also after they got MS.
Music talk with John. Hello.
John.
That's the guy who walk with this and talk, isn't it? I think it's that.
Yeah. I think there was also Honk.
Anahata wrote Heisan, so maybe either he's very, very polite or he might be Scandinavian.
Further up here. What's his name?
Hank.
Arne? No. Hank. Okay.
Anahata. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, yeah. No, so, but I will try to meet you, Stunte, because I will drive my car. I have this electric car, so it's so nice to drive this car. So it's very easy to charge it up, and it.
Scandinavia is pretty well equipped for that. Like, you get superchargers regularly everywhere, so you just stop for 15, 20 minutes, which is good for your health anyway. You drive 400 kilometers for 400 or 500 kilometers, and then you recharge for 20 minutes. That's perfect.
Yeah. This is Hank. He's in Göteborg.
Okay.
Yeah. I think I was in Göteborg on a Bruce Springsteen concert some years ago. That was very nice. But as you say, Stunte, earlier, it's 3-4 hours, and you stand in line, and it's so crowded, and people are dressed up nice, but a little too drunk, and I don't like if people are too drunk on the on the concert. I need to listen to the concert, not to drink. So
for me, I like when the band plays between 50 minutes and 90 minutes. 90 is already a bit too much. I like, unless it's jazz. Jazz is the best for me because you play 25 minutes, then a break, then 25 minutes, then a break, then 25 minutes. Usually you have three. The turntable there.
He was asking about if I have a Tesla, but I have a Ford Mustang. I have a Mustang.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. So.
Yeah, I have.
Is this the real wax rub? You think? I don't know.
Who cares? Like, let them have they can have their drama somewhere else. Let's ignore them.
Yeah. I don't need to pull up. I don't need to pull up everything of the comments.
No, you don't. But Oakenshield here, he's in Sweden.
He's in Sweden, yeah. Okay. Yeah. And this is a question. How is the electric car go handling the winter? Of course, it reduced a lot in the winter, but it's working a lot. But I always have my car in park in my garage, so it's a little bit warm there. It's no minus there, but it's the effect is going a bit reduced in the winter.
But the thing is that during winter, when you're in Sweden or Norway, you don't travel far with the car, even if you have a normal car, a regular car.
So. Of course, Dante. You don't drive so far away if it's not special. So it's only in the summer and early when you use your car. So I like this electric stuff. It's nice. I don't know him. Hi, Ivan. How are you today? Hello. I try to get. I have 866 who follow me, and I try to get up to get 1,000. So it's very difficult. In the beginning, it was so easy, but now it's very, very slow.
You know, don't focus too much on how many people follow you. It's more interesting to have people who watch you.
Yes. So this is my YouTube channel. If you don't follow me if you want. So I have a goal to reach 1,000, but I don't need to earn money. But it could be a little fun to reach 1,000. That's a little secret goal I have. So
no, but you will get, if you do videos regularly, you will get there. Don't worry about that.
This is Pumping Vinyl, I think. Yeah, he is, and Robbie is that they are in a small fight. here, Stunty should get an electric bike. They have been very popular here in Norway, electric bike, but it costs around 10 to 15,000 Norwegian Swedish krona, I think, maybe more.
Yeah, but the thing is that I'm at the age where if I do biking, it's because I also want to to keep in shape. So, but the other day I have a friend. If I go through the forest, it takes me like 15, 20 minutes. I ride the bike to his place, it takes me 35 minutes because it's a long detour. And I took the bike, but
This is so fun. I have 22 people follow me now on the viewing.
Oh, nice.
Hello. It's nice to have you, Stunte, because you like to talk and you have good knowledge about music and record. And that's what I love, music and records.
Yeah, but I mostly saw that you were starting this and I thought like maybe I could come and guide you a little bit with the technical aspects.
Yeah, so this is my version live stream with people on it. Scandinavian partnership. Yeah. So that's neat. This is a nice lady. She also have some live stream with music. I follow her. Yeah.
Yeah. Besides, I don't. To be honest, I don't get to. Oh no, it's not true. I watch quite a lot of VC actually.
Yeah. But it's difficult to watch everything because you must have time to play music, work, eat, and do every stuff. So
you know. I'm because of the way my channel works and also because of what I like, I get about, I would say probably close to between 15 and 20 records in a week. No, around 15 records a week. On
oh, you buy so much. Okay. Yeah. I take about 5 a week or around that.
Which is a lot. Huh? No, but like this week, for example, I got in a... 14 records this week.
Oh, okay, but that's a lot.
And yesterday I was making a deal on 3 records from an African singer, very, very cheap on Discord. Because, you know, there's a lot of stuff that people don't know about. Yes. There's so much stuff. So, if you, like 90% of the stuff it costs less than 10 euros.
Yeah. But the problem, then you must, of course, everything, you order those on Discogs or different people and you get it. Yeah, yeah.
But what I do is often I have everything shipped. For example, if I order stuff from the UK, I have everything shipped to a friend in the UK.
Okay.
And then he ships them to me and mark it as a gift. So I don't pay VAT or customs. And also I save a lot on shipping.
But then he sent private from UK to you as a guest. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. I have friends in America and New Orleans. I have some family there, so I could do that with America and stuff. But I have ordered a lot of music from Reno, this Reno Hi-Fi. So I got this Black Sabbath, and I also I love Fleetwood Mac. So this box with a big box from the guy with the guitar. My head is Lindsey Buckingham.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I can get everything from the States, but of course it costs a little bit with shipment. But in Norway, I think it's the same in Sweden. You must pay custom, and maybe it's 20% of the price.
So it's 20 plus the custom handling fee, which is 104 crowns, which is about $10.
Yeah.
So for example, if I buy something that costs me $3 and I pay 20% of tax on it, which is almost nothing, but then they add 104 crowns of. So you want to, and they always, even when you have
only one record, but then you have 3, 4, 5 records, maybe perfect.
And they almost always try to get it. So often I have stuff sent to me marked the right way, and they say to me, I have to pay this. So I have to put a claim. Thankfully, now I don't have to call them and stay like an hour on the phone waiting. I just know where to send an email, what to write in it, and it takes like a week, 10 days of like being stuck in limbo hell. But then you get it, and
it's custom between Sweden and Norway also. So
Because Norway is unfortunately for us not in the European Union.
Yeah. I can show you one record, a Swedish record that I just got last week. I'm so happy with it. It's a little. Let me see.
Yeah. Thank you, B-Side, for the kind words. Yeah. I stream when I can. All right.
Let me see if you heard about this guy.
Ted, no, I haven't.
Yeah, it's called Ted Järstad.
He looks like he's 17.
Yeah, this is an old record. And let me see.
What label is that on?
It's on, this is a little expensive because It's Polar Music Records.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah. And I can show you, let me see if I see.
Jag ska fånga en äng, ja, sol, vind och
vatten. And the song I like is Åh, vilken härlig dag. First song on page 2.
What a beautiful day.
Yeah, and it's so upbeat and everything. And I saw this, I listened to, this song was used in a theater piece in my hometown 4 years ago. And then I found out this was Ted Gjerstad, and I tried to find this record 4 years, but last 2 weeks ago, I found it on a Norwegian, a Swedish buyer, and they sent it to me. So I'm so happy.
How much was it?
It cost, this in dollar, it cost, let me see, it cost $20, 200 Norwegian. Yeah, yeah.
It's cheaper than most new records.
Yeah, yeah. But it's, so I'm so very happy with this. So they have made a documentary of this guy, Ted Gjerstad. Yeah, I think he took suicide or something. He died yeah. Very young, I think. Yeah.
Arne is writing that he was big in the 70s here.
Yes, yes, that's true.
But I wasn't in Sweden back then.
No, okay. Because I've been always living in Norway, and some music is like, Sweden and Norway.
Is it like folk, pub rock, folk?
Yeah, pop music maybe. Before ABBA, I think Ted Gjerstad was also, this Swedish producer also produced one of his albums. I'm not 100% sure, but I think it. You will find Ted Gjerstad.
Is it a little bit... Is it a little bit hippie-ish?
Yeah, a little bit hippie-ish. Yeah.
Like
yeah.
Almost every music, almost all the music in Sweden in the 70s was a little bit hippie.
Yeah, it's true. Yeah.
Oh, Oakenshield says the musicians on it are legends. So I assume maybe Janne Schaffer is playing on it.
Yeah, I think so. But let me see. Hey, it's Ted. Kenneth Gjerstad, let me see. Benny Andersson, piano.
Oh,
ABBA.
Yeah. ABBA.
Benny Andersson, Ted Gjerstad, elgitar, Janne Schaffer, akustisk gitar, Janne Schaffer. Bjørn Ulvaeus også. Bjørn Ulvaeus fra ABBA. Yeah. Trommer Ole Brunkert, Roger Palm, bass Mike Watson. Yeah. Benny Andersson, he plays a lot of... Okay, I see it. Yeah. In January, December, December 72 and February 1973 was recorded. Yeah, it's a picture of Benny also. You ever see that?
Oh, yeah. That's
yeah. So this record I recommend for your Scandinavian people. This is a fun record. This is the first record he made. It's a fun record.
This one?
Björn Sundli. No, I don't hear about that. See the funky stuff or...
So this feature is, let me see who's playing there. Jan Schaffer, Kenny Håkansson. So it's Palle Danielsson is a free jazz bass player. This is really good psychedelic music in general.
Oh, I make solo layout.
With a fun cover.
Okay. Yeah. I must practice to get you big and me small and back again. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So it's 3 dots at the right corner. Then you can click big and small.
And this is on Sveriges Radio Records. National Radio, which is later.
Yeah.
It's a fun record. Well, maybe I'll play it tonight, actually.
Yeah. And Seb is here. Yeah, hello. Hallo. Han bor i Sør-Norge, nærheten Haugesund, gjør du ikke det? Bergen, Haugesund, on the West Coast.
Hvor langt ifrån deg, da?
Oh, that's a little bit. It's you must fly 1 hour and yeah, so I fly to Oslo. Yeah, it's a long drive.
Or it would be 10 hours, okay. Yeah,
25 hours with car.
Wow.
Yeah. Because I live in the north and he's living in the southwest.
Yeah, and it's not like you got like motorways from the north.
No. If I fly from my place to Oslo, the headquarters is very close to Stockholm, of course, Oslo, Stockholm. It takes 1 hour and 30 minutes with the plane. But if I drive, it will take 23 hours.
Yeah,
and Stavanger on the west coast. So then I must cross the mountains and back to Stavanger. So that will take more, 3 hours more. So
I think driving from Stockholm to Oslo is about 7-8 hours only.
Yeah, I think so. It's going. I've taken a bus once and a train before, also night train. This is Sander Nilsen. He's from my town. Hey, Sander. He is the founder of Innebandy. You know, Innebandy is very big in Sweden.
Yeah. It's like, only in Scandinavia, I think.
Yeah. So it's
like outdoor hockey, but inside.
Yes. and in my town, we have a team that is in the first division, the elite division. So everyone go to the games. It's around 500 people-ish on the games. So it's very, very fun. I like it. Floorball. Maybe it's floorball. Is that the English word for it? Innebandy? No, I'm not sure. It's just use a stick also and a scoreboard.
It's like ice hockey.
Yeah, inside.
But inside and without ice.
Yes. And it's very popular in Sweden, of course.
I think Sweden is probably the number one country for that sport.
Yeah, they call it floorball, yeah. Mm.
Let's put it that way. It's not the most TV-genic sport to watch.
No. But if you are close, you see that live. That's fun because you see the ball. Yeah. But the same with ice hockey. If you on the screen, it's not, you don't see the puck. So yeah. This is a calmer morning show. Yeah. Maybe we should do this. Stunty as a tradition, have one morning show against.
During the summer when we can.
In the summer we can. Yeah.
Well, maybe it's.
The problem with Rachel, I love Rachel everything, but this politic talks, it's too much for me because I'm so far away, and both of those two people that are going to be president are not the best fit for their country. So, I get it. I need music talk. So.
Yeah, but it's also the whole drama thing, and gets like, and people who act like characters supposedly.
Yeah, it's a show also, so it's okay.
Yeah, but because you see, you and me now we're talking. I'm the same as I am.
Yeah.
If we meet in real life, I think it will be exactly the same.
Yeah, that's true.
Except we'll speak a little less English.
But sometimes some words in Swedish is not so easy. But Norway and Sweden have been very close. But sometimes I must switch to English.
I think it's harder for me to understand Norwegian than it is for you to understand Swedish. Yes. Though, even of course it is because I'm not Swedish originally. But I think even if you are, it's not just that. It's also depending where you're from in Norway and where you're from in Sweden, because the
dialect
is so dramatically. Like Stockholm is very neutral, so it must be the easiest for you to understand, right? Of the Swedish.
Yeah, I can tell you a story about that, Stunty, because I don't know if you know her, but I think it was early 90s. It was one lady in Sweden called Lena Philipsson. She was a famous singer in Sweden, Lena Philipsson. Okay. And she was so hot in Sweden. It was number one on the charts 3-4 years. And then she was coming to my hometown. And I work in a local radio station for 15 years as spare time work. I finished my ordinary work, I worked there. And then I got an interview deal with her. And I interviewed her before the show in the daytime on the grass, on the sunshine and everything. And then I start to speak Norwegian, of course, because she is Swedish. But she didn't understand nothing. So, and then I must switch to English and, of course, translate for my listener that listen to the local radio, because that's only in Norwegian. So, and she could not understand me. And I think it's easier for us Norwegian to understand Swedish that Swedish to Norwegian, Swedish people to understand Norwegian. So I think you have right, Stanley.
Well, it's funny to think that at one point in history, it probably was the same language, but if I try to emulate how someone speaks in the south of Sweden, it would be "ska vi gå på krogen."
Yeah, yeah.
If I say the same thing in Stockholm, "ska vi gå på krogen."
Ska vi gå på krogen?
If you say it more in the north,
"ska vi gå på," actually, "ska vi gå på krogen." I have more live in it, more not not bokstav, not letter for letter.
It's like in Stockholm, the letter R doesn't exist. It's almost like an L. Like when you pronounce it, it's always more rolling and less. Whereas in Skåne.
Skåne, that's difficult.
They know the R.
Danish speak. If they speak Danish people, it's a little difficult for me to understand. But it's easier to read because the Danish and Norwegian is very close to if you read it.
It's closer, I think, Norwegian and Danish. Like as you said, the letters in the alphabet. Nice ladies.
Oh, Nico, I want that. That's a nice one.
That's the original pressing. But it's the stereo, not the mono. Still, it's pretty good. Here's something Swedish.
Rena Rama, what's that?
Rena Rama, it's sort of folk hippie jazz band from as they used to do in the 70s.
Okay.
And it's got some really good jazz musicians, Bobo Stenson, Palle Danielsson again, and Bengt Berger. Lennart Åberg is the more traditional one of the bunch, but still. Yeah. A lot of jokes we can do that no one will understand.
I'm spam a little bit on the chat. They are talking to each other, but I don't highlight that. So I'm agree. We are just relaxing and talking music and about life and everything. So just chill out, people. It's summer here in North Norway. We enjoy the summer also because we don't have so many. Oh, he's from Croatia. Nice.
Yeah, the name sounded Balkanic.
Have you been in Croatia? I've never been there, Stunty. I think it's a very nice summer country also to visit.
Yeah. Well, I've been to Serbia. I haven't been to Croatia.
Hello, Vinyl Dreamscape. Hello.
Hello, Sean.
Yeah. Oh, you know his name.
He's Sean. He's from Detroit.
Oh, from Detroit. The place that they build all these cars.
Also techno music.
Oh, he's in tech. Oh, you're into techno also, Stante.
Techno was started in Detroit.
Okay. In the 90s, I was not, you know, I got the first kid.
It was in the 80s.
Okay, the 80s, yeah. But it of the techno music is not so much for me.
It's like everything for me. Like, you just need to find the one thing that you like. And then it opens the door, and you don't like to. I don't like everything in jazz. I don't like everything in rock. Like, it's just. But the first techno record was probably Cybotron, which is Ron Atkins, Cosmic Cars in 84, 85.
Yes.
So that's 40 years ago.
Yeah, I remember the techno scene in Norway. That was maybe in the 90s, because I was a father in 97. I didn't go out so much then, but I'm more disco and soul and R&B and I was just looking on YouTube with the story of Bonnie M, the German pop disco group Bonnie M, and I like that.
You know, Norway probably has some of the biggest names in the new disco scene, which is basically house that is like disco, balearic pop, like Lindström, Prins Thomas, disco Jocke, Todd Terje,
Todd Terje. I have Todd Terje, Lindstrøm. I have some of those records on vinyl also. I like them because they mix the disco and the techno, but it's more smoother. It's not so
it's like pop music, but not necessarily with songs.
Yeah.
And they're great producers.
Yes, yes.
Oh, I'm glad you know of them.
I know about them, and I have some of this. And I have a friend that I will find that record. I have a friend that is a techno guy. He have made a, I will pick them up vinyl. Enjoy the people when I'm looking for it. Just behind me.
Yeah. Oh my God, guys! I really have nothing better to do than. Than to bitch about each other there, huh? Okay, well, as long as you don't do it on your channels, that makes it okay, I guess.
This is a techno. He's from my town. It's called Jan Marius, and he was a DJ. It's a techno DJ, and he was also playing with a lot of Todd Terje, the producer. And this is called Infinitive Zest. And let me see.
And it's a double album.
Yeah, it's on two. It's on two records. Yeah.
Yep.
You see, I think it's not so easy to get it, but you can stream it.
What so label is that on?
Yeah, I can see. And this is it's a friend of mine. He was working on my local radio station also in the but I don't see it's and it, maybe it's not. It should be on the label. Let me see. Pure Funk is the name of that.
Yeah. I know it.
Infinity Test, Pure Funk. I cannot see any label here.
I think a lot
I see it. It's called Alu Records Norway 2019. Groove okay. Elastic Sounds.
I don't know it.
No. So, but if you should listen to it on the streaming, and this is for you. It's the music you like. Infinity Pure Funk.
I like. I potentially like everything apart from heavy metal, and Gubbjas.
Yeah, Gubbjas. Yeah, this is same for me. I don't like heavy metal, but I bought this Black Sabbath this Reno release.
Yeah,
I got rough. It. I have not opened it, but I have it. Yeah.
You know, sometime I should do like a stream playing only all the records that people send me for free. You know, to when I get a record and they put other records, either as presents or just to solidify like stuff.
Yeah,
like
that. I've got that too. Also, that's fun. Yeah. That's
I
fun.
Get
also.
These and you know you can't throw them in the garbage. Hello,
but
Alex.
But you got the record also. It's not the only cover. It's everything.
Yeah.
Okay. Nice. Yeah. Yeah. I see it. Oh, this guy Dino. He's collecting records. So they have 760 records.
How old are you, Dino?
Yeah. I must learn to... it's a new... I think he's younger than us.
Yeah. The picture, if the picture is representative, who knows? He might be like 17, 16, 17.
and this is...
a lot of records at that age.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. So I must try to follow the chat also. That's also new for me.
Talk and
follow. It's so different. I cannot highlight everyone because some people here is just complaining and.
Yeah, or talking about the politics.
yeah, that's true. What about the techno is much more diversity than most people think. Stunty knows the good stuff. Kenny Large, I never heard about Kenny Large's and Jeff Mills. That's good stuff, Stunty?
Yeah. Jeff Mills has been around since the late 80s, and he's still like one of the leading figures. Some of the stuff he's done, like soundtracks for movies, silent movies, and stuff like that. He does music for dance as well, like ballet.
Okay.
But but he's still like very techno, but there is some real techno that is really melodic. There is techno that is hard, and now these are Detroit techno guys. There is also techno from everywhere, obviously, from Sweden, Belgium, Germany, the UK, or probably with the US, the three other countries that are the biggest ones for.
But Detroit, are they known for hard techno more?
No. Detroit techno is its own thing in a way. So sometimes it can be very hard, but it's always okay. Let's put it that way. Techno was born in the 80s under Reagan.
Yeah.
So people were working at factories, and there was a lot of racism. If you look at all the covers of the techno records of the 80s, it's always spaceships, outer space, and stuff like that. It's not necessarily technology. It's technology to get to space. And what is getting to space, to another world, an alien world for a black guy in Reagan America? It's escaping the brutality of the police and all that. So in a way, techno is a very romantic kind of music in a literary way. Like it is a sort of metaphor of escapism. This world is not for me, doesn't want me, let's go somewhere else. And of course it's coming from disco, from funk, from electro, and a bunch of others. But the people who created that, it was a reaction to racism as well. You can't ignore that if you want to understand it. When techno got much harder, it was mostly to please European audiences who wanted the more radical. The first techno guys from Detroit, when they got booked to play in Europe during the weekend, they were shocked, because when they were DJing in Detroit and around there, they would play 4 or 5 hours, but they wouldn't play only techno. They would play funk, they would play hip-hop, they would play techno. And when they were booked in Europe, the clubs wanted them to play 4 hours of techno, which they had never done that, because that was not how it was done there. So that's one of the way the whole scene like grew, changed, evolved. So you can imagine that like there is so much room for... There's the ambient techno that doesn't have like a boom, boom, boom.
Yeah. Because I know that, of course, last disco was coming because people was unemployed and had not have work and just chill out. And Detroit they closed all the cars, shops and fabrics, and maybe therefore the techno was starting there. So in Norway, some place they go to abandoned places, bunkers, and they start this techno show. And it was very, very, very hard, and smoke machine. And there was some accident also. It was some, they lost the oxygen. And so it was a bad story about that techno also. But
don't read the comments now. Now they're full on.
Okay. But we have reached out. We have 28 live, and Rachel are stopped. So maybe people are coming over here.
Yeah. I won't be able to stay too long because
we're gonna end soon. Also, I'm gonna have a dinner also. But let me just read this small comment at the end here. Even what you think about Beach Boys and what's your favorite album by them? I like this Good Vibration song, and I have this. Famous Pet Sounds with Beach Boys, and I found a very good sounding copy also. I don't remember, but it's very good. It's both stereo and mono, isn't it? I like stereo best.
So Dino is 20 years old, has 760 records, is from Croatia.
Two
questions. Like, that's a lot of records at that age. How did that happen? And also, how did you find Ivan's channel?
Yeah, that's interesting. Yeah. Thank you. You're helping me. This is very, very, very good.
Well, Have
a good working day. It's dinner time. It's 10 minutes. 6:10. Here. I can time it out, but I don't do that for it.
Well, you should, but like maybe you
If
have
the
to.
trouble, if the trouble a lot, so I could do that also, but cancer body. Oh, it's a lot of stuff here. Oh.
I think they're talking about Tangerine Dream.
Okay, this is Wyoming Dave. Hello, Wyoming Dave. I like him. He is sometimes on some streams I watch. Yeah.
Yeah, he is there. He doesn't talk a lot, but
No, he is there, yeah. But me and Dave have we like Duran Duran. I bought the last album, this Halloween album from Duran Duran, and I really like it. And Duran Duran, they just today they relaunched the five first records from Duran Duran. It's remastered
You
and it's
know, I like Duran Duran Duran.
three
It's
Durans, yeah.
no, there's a band called Duran Duran
Oh.
Duran,
Oh.
and it's like breakcore. It's like
Okay.
really crazy music,
Okay.
and yeah, it's almost like a taking the piss band, but it's kind of like Aphex Twin when he's really hardcore.
I
Yeah,
never
he
heard of, I
released.
never heard about them, but
Oh,
I
they're
heard of
not
one in the 80s, maybe it was one group called Death. You
the
remember them?
yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah,
So
it's
they
Mark, what's his name? He's an English guy originally.
UK, yeah,
Yeah.
English, yeah.
And he had like a solo album that is amazing on 4AD, and then he got success with the which is it's what's his name again? Someone help us.
Yeah, help us with that there.
Oh, Dino found you through Joe Mayo.
Let me see, go down. Hey, we only like
Hello, Brian.
I see Rachel and other people who live stream. If you got a lot of people in the chat, it's not so easy to get them out in put them on the screen and everything. Oh, here's Dino. Yeah, Joe Mayer. Yeah, he is always in the morning. It's before Rachel's stream, and he talk about a lot of stuff. But he's a big Beatles fan.
Yeah, he doesn't talk about a lot of stuff, be honest,
No.
Ivan. He talks about the
That's true.
Beatles.
He talk about Bill, and sometimes he's too. Yeah, yeah,
Political.
but yeah, it's okay. But yeah,
Matt
Brian.
Johnson. Thank you, Hank.
Yeah, okay.
Matt
Brian
Johnson
C,
is
hello.
the guy who did the
Okay, yeah, that's okay. I didn't know that. Yeah.
Yeah. You should check his first solo album from the 80s is more experimental, but it's really good. Really, really good. He has Yeah, it's they got this hit in the second album or the first album. This is the
Yeah.
day that every TV show on Netflix is that is feel good is using that song. That has a nice accordion solo in it, which is quite unusual in pop music.
Yeah, okay, I see. Matt Johnson, yeah, I can Google it, of course. That's also nice if you Google it. Soul Mining was the first album from 83.
Yeah, that's the
Mind
one.
Bomb, I remember that. Now, this was fun. Maybe we should end it here. It's 1 hour and 38 minutes. That's my first live stream. And I play music in the beginning, and then Stunty was coming up and helped me. That's Scandinavian Fellowship, but that's good.
Yeah, if you want more like advice and all that, you have my Instagram, so we
Yes,
can
I have that. So thanks everyone for the stream and your like and subscribe and see you later and have a good
Bye
summer,
bye.
Stunty. Bye
You
bye.
too.
Yeah, hola.
Oh, yeah. So you put like you put
At the
ending
right
live
up.
up there.
Yeah, and ask once more. Okay, two times. Yeah. Yes. Hey, Arne. Ha det bra, Arne.
Hello.
Ha det.